So now I want to show you another type of turtle program we can send to the plotter machine.
You're there waiting for your next job.
Yeah. And we're going to continue with this idea of just giving it a list of angles to turn through. And I just need to find some source of angles. And I thought maybe let's look at the digits of numbers like pi and that kind of thing. Here we have our original thing where we started exploring the Euler spiral. Like, what if I just start sending the digits of pi? Eight, four, six.
Okay. Wow, you know that many off by heart.
I know more than that, but the next one is a two.
Okay.
Yeah, you always need to just know one more. If I sent this would just be like 3 radians, 1 radian and stuff. I think what would make more sense would be to do, well, what I've marked up on this here, I've split this into 10 directions. So if I do, for the first three, if I do 1, 2, 3, I could, that might make more sense. So I'll be turning 3/10 of a full turn. And then I'll turn, you know, then I'll turn 1/10, then 4/10, 1/10, 5, 9, and then we'll see what picture gets drawn.
So does that mean one will be 36 degrees?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we're doing multiples of 36 degrees. So yeah, let's put in that, 36 degrees. It would have been pointing this way and it turned back 3/10 to go up this way. And then here it turned just 36 degrees, the smallest amount it can turn, and so on. Here, when it got to a 5, you'll notice that it just did a 180 degree turn, because 5/10 is a half. Anytime you see a 5, that just means it goes back. So if I see 2 5s, basically it doesn't do anything, right? Yeah, so let's draw more. We're going to stick to base 10 to start with. And then it will do this picture, it will plot the turtle drawing for that number. So here we have pi in base 10, and let's do 3,000 steps of pi. We get this picture here, kind of like a fractal island or sort of wild walk going around everywhere. Let's do more digits, see what it looks like. So here's 10,000. Original picture, I think, was up in this corner here. Now it's branched off and gone all over here. Thousand, 100,000. So like here is some way of visualizing the digits of pi. It's just sort of come out from playing around with turtle programs.
I've got so many questions come into my mind, like, where will it ultimately go? Will it ever come back to the start? Will every possible shape be formed at some point? Like, yeah. you know how they say the monkey's writing Shakespeare? Will you eventually draw the Mona Lisa just by luck?
Right, like, yeah. Yeah, I have those same questions as well. One conjecture about pi is that it's normal. The digits of pi are normal, meaning that every possible sequence that you could think of, 0, 1, up to 3, up to 9, would be in the digits of pi. That, I guess that means if you had some shape that you could draw with 36 degrees turn, you would expect that shape to eventually show up in this drawing. I guess you don't know exactly where on the paper it would be, right? So I don't know if you would expect, after drawing for infinitely long, would you just have like a black sheet of paper that's fully filled in with ink?
When you get a very long string of zeros, yeah, you'll get like really long straight lines.
Long straight line, yeah. Another question I think is natural to ask is like, if I gave you this picture, could you have worked out the digits of pi? Right? Or if I sent someone, this is like a secret message, or I broadcast this across the universe as like a sign that there's some intelligence on Earth, would it be a good way to show like, hey, we know about pi? Let's do 3,000, so we get this kind of like dancing off away from the main kind of hub. Thank you. Pi, base 10, almost 3,000 digits. Base 10 is arbitrary, right? So, I mean, do you want to try a different base? Got one in mind?
Whoa, let's go base 3.
Base 3 is cool. So let's change the base to 3 and let's boost up to 10,000 points. So one cool thing about base 3 is that our turns are going to be 120 degrees. That means that we're going to be constrained to this triangular grid, triangles that tessellate the plane. Whereas with base 10, we have this weird 36 degree angle. It's kind of like pentagons, right? And pentagons don't tile the plane, so you can get a real mess. You're always going to have sort of collections of triangles if you use base 3.
So will base 4 give us squares?
Yeah, that's right. So now we've got squares. I like this as maybe if I needed to generate some kind of like roads for a zoomed out city in a video game or something, you might, you know, create a network like this.
They look like world maps to me.
Yeah. Yeah, some people say they kind of look like ways to generate an island. They look like Japan, maybe. We could do more, we could do 100,000 in base 4. So I chose Pi because I want like an infinite list of turns that is just going to spew out the Mona Lisa at some point. Less interesting digit sequence would just be rational number. So let's change Pi to a seventh. I like a seventh because it's 0.142857142857. If you do that enough, you're just going to end up back where you started in the same orientation, and you're going to create a rotationally symmetric picture like this. Make it like 1 over some bigger prime, like I guess 119 is a prime, probably. Then you get a more detailed but still rotationally symmetric picture. It's kind of a nice way to see a stark difference between rational numbers and irrational numbers. Do more irrational numbers, so we try E. So let's do E, base 10, 100,000.
That's a cool little place. There's a lagoon.
Yeah, this seems like an unlikely configuration.
That looks like Britain up there.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Yeah.
We're here right now.
Yep. Scotland.
Yeah. I like golden ratio. So what you got? Square root of 5 plus 1. In some sense, the most irrational number. I don't know if it gives the sort of most squiggly map, but it looks cool to me.
Imagine if you just put some arbitrary number in one day, like randomly, and pressed it, and your face appeared.
Yeah. Or, conversely, could somebody send me the number that draws my face?
Ah. Is this the Feynman point? It's 6 9s, 9 9 9, 9 9 9. So that won't be beaten. There is a string of 7 threes, but that takes another 710,000 digits. So we'll be nearly 3/4 of the way down the mile of pi before we find a longer string of the same digit. And the first one is within the first 2 meters.